In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Today's Holy Mass is offered for the souls of Christina Susai, Catherine Joseph, Regina Gideon, Ketruth Joseph, Albert De Cruz. We pray for all these souls offered by Dominic, Sunita and family. Today also we offered for the other intentions, Harrison Moses Marianne, for the intentions of Felix Emmanuel, Akash Paul Anthony, Vijay Mary, Anuj Virgil D'Souza, Philomena D'Souza. We also pray for Mrs. Atkinson, especially speedy recovery of Rhoda Atkinson. Thanksgiving by Marian and Amar family. Also thanksgiving for Stephen Spandon. Also for those who are infected with coronavirus. And also we pray for Lourdes Rodriguez. Today, the whole Mother Church celebrates Jesus as the Lord and Savior. So we pray that may the Lord, who is our King and our Savior, take control of our lives and lead us. We surrender ourselves and our families, especially when our nation and the whole world is going through the pain of coronavirus, we pray that Jesus takes control of it as He is our Lord and heal the church, heal His people and heal the nations. And we pray in a very special way for all those who are participating in this Holy Mass from different places, from all over India and the world. They are participating in this Mass. We pray for all of them, that may all their families be blessed and may all their families be dedicated to Jesus, the King and the Lord. We also offered this Mass for the repose of soul of Lourdes Mary, offered by Emmanuel. For the moments we have failed to accept Him as our Lord, we ask pardon and mercy. Lord, have mercy on us all. Lord, have mercy on us. Lord, have mercy. mercy on us all. Lord, have mercy on us. Christ, have mercy on us all. Christ, have mercy on us. Christ, have mercy on us all. Christ, have mercy on us. Lord, have mercy on us all. Lord, have mercy on us. Lord, have mercy on us all. Lord, have mercy on us. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who has an example of humility for the human race to follow, caused our Savior to take flesh and submit to the cross. Graciously grant that we may heed His lesson of patient suffering and so merit a share in His resurrection, who lives and reigns with You in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
First reading, a reading from the book of prophet Isaiah, chapter 50, verses 4 to 7. First reading, a reading from the book of prophet Isaiah, chapter 50, verses 4 to 7. The Lord God has given me the tongue of those who are taught, that I may know how to sustain with a word that is weary. Morning by morning He wakens. He wakens my ear to hear as those who are taught. The Lord God has opened my ear, and I was not rebellious. I turned not backward. I gave my back to the smiters and my cheeks to those who have pulled out the beard. I hid not my face from shame and spitting. For the Lord God helps me, therefore I have not been confounded. Therefore I have set my face like the flint, and I know that I shall not be put to shame. The word of God.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus, You are my way. 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 You you are my King.
He humbled himself. Therefore, God has highly exalted him. Second reading, a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians, chapter 2, verses from 6 to 11. Letter of St. Paul to the Philippians, chapter 2, verses from 6 to 11. Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not count equality with God a thing to be grasped, but emptied himself, taking the form of a servant, being born in the likeness of men. And being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God has highly exalted him and bestowed on him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of God.
Thanks be to God.
Bless the Lord, my soul.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Chapter 26. Now, Jesus stood before the governor, and the governor asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" Jesus said to him, "You have said so." But when he was accused by the chief priests and the elders, he made no answer. Then Pilate said to him, "Do you not hear how many things they testify against you?" But he gave him no answer. Not even a single charge. Not even to a single charge. So that the governor wondered greatly. Now at the feast, the governor was accustomed to release for the crowd any one prisoner whom they wanted. And they had then a notorious prisoner called Barabbas. So when they had gathered, Pilate said to them, "Whom do you want me to release for you, Barabbas or Jesus, who is called Christ?" For he knew that it was out of the envy that they had delivered him up. Besides, while he was sitting on the judgment seat, his wife sent word to him, "Have nothing to do with this righteous man. For I have suffered much over him today in a dream." Now the chief priests and the elders persuaded the people to ask for Barabbas and destroy Jesus. The governor again said to them, "Which of the two do you want me to release for you?" And they said, "Barabbas." Pilate said to them, "Then what shall I do with Jesus, who is called Christ?" They all said, "Let him be crucified." Then he said, "Why? What evil has he done?" But they shouted all the more, "Let him be crucified." So when Pilate saw that he was gaining nothing, but rather that a riot was beginning, he took water and washed his hands before the crowd, saying, "I am innocent of this righteous man's blood. See to it to yourselves." And all the people gathered. They answered, "His blood be on us and on our children." Then he released Father Barabbas, and having scourged Jesus, delivered him to be crucified. Then the soldiers of the governor took Jesus into the praetorium, and they gathered the whole battalion before him, and they stripped him and put a scarlet robe upon him, and plaiting crown of thorns, they put it on his head and put a reed in his right hand. And kneeling before him, they mocked him, saying, "Hail, King of the Jews!" And they spat upon him and took the reed and struck him on the head. And when they had mocked him, they stripped him of the robe and put his own clothes on him and led him away to crucify him. As they were marching out, they came upon a man of Cyrene, Simon by name. This man they compelled to carry his cross. And when they came to a place called Golgotha, which means the place of a skull, they offered him wine to drink, mingled with gall. But when he tasted it, he would not drink it. And when they had crucified him, they divided his garments among them by casting lots. Then they sat down and kept watch over him there. And over his head, they put the charge against him, which read, "This is Jesus, the King of the Jews." Then two robbers were crucified with him, one on the right and one on the left. And those who passed by derided him, wagging their heads and saying, "You who would destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself. If you are the Son of God, come down from the cross." So also the chief priests with the scribes and elders mocked him, saying, "He saved others, he cannot save himself. He is the King of Israel. Let him come down now from the cross and we will believe in him. He trusts in God. Let God deliver him now if he disobeys him. For he said, 'I am the Son of God.'" And the robbers who were crucified with him also reviled him in the same way. Now from the sixth hour, there was darkness over all the land until the ninth hour. And about the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice, "Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani?" That is, my God, why hast thou forsaken me?" And some of the bystanders hearing it said, "This man is calling Elijah." And one of them at once ran and took a sponge, filled it with vinegar, and put it on a reed, and gave it to him to drink. But the others said, "Wait, let us see whether Elijah will come to save him." And Jesus cried out with a loud voice and yielded up his spirit. And behold, the curtain of the temple was torn into two, from top to bottom, and the earth shook, and the rocks were split. The tombs also were opened, and many bodies of the saints who had fallen asleep were raised. And coming out of the tombs after his resurrection, they went into the holy city and appeared to many. When the centurion and those who were with him, keeping watch over Jesus, saw the earthquake and what took place, they were filled with awe and said, "Truly, this was the Son of God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear friends, today, before our Lord started his holy journey to Jerusalem, he sends his two of his disciples. He tells two of the disciples to go ahead and to go to that village which is ahead of them, and there you will find a donkey with its younger one tied up, and you go and bring them to me. My dear friends, when I read this, what the Holy Spirit told me is, Jesus told the disciples that he needed a donkey, because the donkey is the sign of a king. This is what we read in the book of 1 Kings chapter 1, where David prepares the donkey for his son Solomon before anointing him as the king. And Solomon travels on the donkey. And we also read in the book of Zechariah, chapter 9, verse 9, where the prophet says, "Here comes your king riding on a donkey to Jerusalem." Yes, Jesus is coming as the king. He is coming willing to be a king for all of us. And he sends the disciples, "You go ahead, and what is needed for you, God will do for you." The disciples have not seen the donkey, and they were wondering, even if there is donkey, will they allow them to untie? And Jesus gives the word, saying, "Tell them this is needed for the Lord." They carry this word and they went ahead. My dear friends, it is God's word, as we read in Psalm 107 verse 20. Through God's word, God's mighty, powerful presence will go before us. And through his word, he did everything for them. He healed them and protected them from the destruction. This is what the word of God says. We read in 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 23 onwards. It says, "The flowers may fade away, the grass may dry away, but not the word of God." The word that comes from the mouth of God. Yes, that's why Jesus said in Matthew 4:4, "Man lives by the word that proceeds from the mouth of God. My dear friends, these two disciples, they are going ahead. They are going ahead to find a donkey and bring it. Though their minds might have been in doubt, will it happen to us? Will there be a donkey? Will they allow us? 101 questions might have come. No. They were holding on to the promise. They have seen what the word of God, what Jesus has spoken in the past, and how it has exactly taken place. So with that word, they went to the village. And lo and behold, they saw and they realized that the word of God led them ahead. The word of God pushed them ahead and saw the donkey, untied the donkey. And the people asked them, why are you untying the donkey? And they said, this is needed for the Lord. My dear friends, when we carry the word of God with us, we reach the destiny which where God wants us to be. Many of the times, if we depend on our thinking, many doubts, many fears, many worries may come. But if we carry the word of God, we will definitely reach our destiny. We will definitely do the needful and be successful in our lives. It is the word of God which will help us to go ahead in life. God has given us the gift of God's word, that amidst many struggles, many doubting things, many sickness and brokenness, we are victorious people, will go ahead in life, because the words we receive is from the words of the King who rules heaven and the earth. Yes. And the disciples, when they were about to untie, those people asked them, why are you untying? Jesus is teaching us, when things happen and the things are going to be an obstacle for us, all that we need to do is repeat what Jesus has given to us. You repeat what Jesus has spoken, and that will break every barrier, and you will receive the blessing. You will reach the destiny. The disciple did not get upset. They did not try to make those people happy by saying something or trying to explain the situation. No. They just said the word which Jesus gave them. This is needed for the master. They never thought, if we say master, they may ask, who is this smart master? But no, they never doubted the word of God. And they just repeated what Jesus has said. And immediately they allowed them to take the donkey. Yes, hold on to the word of God. And God will fulfill your need. He will never fail us. The word of God is the word of the King. And this word is available for you and me. For Jesus wants to be our King, our Lord. And he has given us. We may not be able to see Jesus with our naked eyes, but we have his word with us. That's why Jesus said in John's Gospel, chapter 6, verse 63, if you hold on to my word will give you my life and my own spirit. That's why Jesus told the disciples in John's Gospel, chapter 15, verse 7, if you remain in me and my word remains in you, whatever you ask will be granted to you. I remember once a lady was living in a very big pipe where I was, a place called Muthangi, where I was the director. And nearby, there were so many big pipes. The poor people were staying there. They close on the one side. On the other side, they keep open and keep some kind of door, and they used to survive. One day, a lady, a very poor lady, uneducated lady, carrying the Bible, Telugu Bible, she was coming to the church. I asked her, "Mother, do you read the Bible? You are carrying the word of God." She said, "Father, you don't know the power of the word of God. In our region, there was a very big snake, and it has bitten three, one elderly man and two children. So we were all afraid which moment that snake will come." One day, as I was sitting inside the so-called very big pipe, like her own house, and I was thinking something, suddenly I noticed this huge snake, cobra, raising its head, it was coming. All that I had was the word of God. I just kept the Bible, friend. And do you remember what you said last Sunday? A sentence you told us to repeat. "My grace is sufficient for you. In your weakness, my strength will sustain you." I kept the Bible and I was not afraid. I was just saying the word. I do not know how many times I said, "My grace is sufficient for you. In your weakness, my strength will sustain you. My grace is sufficient for you. In your weakness, my strength will sustain you." It came near, Father. As soon as it saw the Bible, it bowed down and it went away. "This is my experience," she said. And not only that, she said, from that day onwards, we don't see the snake anymore. Now it is almost 3 months have passed. That's why I carry the word. The late Bishop of Pune, Bishop Valerian D'Souza, he used to say, "Carry the word, and the word will carry you, and the word will lead you to the King of Kings." And that's what happened. Today, as we celebrate Jesus our King, we should know that when we carry His word, the King Himself will be with us to fulfill what He has spoken to us. And He will give us His Spirit, the Holy Spirit, to fulfill the word of God. Yes. So in our life journey, the word of God, number one, make us to proceed ahead in life. The disciples, they caught the word of God from Jesus. "Go and you will find a donkey. You untie and you bring them to me." So they heard the word of God. They were holding the word of God in their hearts, and the word of God made them to proceed in life. My dear friends, there are many obstacles in our lives. Take the word. It is the word that will make us to go ahead in life, in spite of all the problems. We read in the book of Exodus, chapter 14, verse 15. When Moses was crying before God, "Before we have Red Sea, behind us there are the enemies. Now what shall we do?" God said, "Go ahead." The word of God was revealed to Moses. "Go ahead." Yes. Moses caught hold of the word of God, the promise, and he went ahead. And we know they crossed the Red Sea. They overcame the enemy. We read in the book of Isaiah, chapter 48, verse 17. "Your God Himself goes before you, and He will make the path for you." Hold on to His word. Yes. That's why we read in the book of Matthew, chapter 28, verse 7. When Mary Magdalene was crying for Jesus in the tomb, the angels appeared to her and said, you are searching for Jesus who is living among the dead. Go and tell the disciples that the risen Savior is going ahead of them. And they will see him in Galilee. Yes, the word of God always asks us to go ahead. If we hold on to the word of God, let any obstacle comes, we will go ahead. So Jesus the King makes us to move ahead in life in spite of all the obstacles through his word. Second, when people obstruct us, when problems come to stand against us, we not only move with the word of God, we repeat what Jesus has said. And then we find that obstacles are broken. The people who were even the owners, they allowed the donkey to be taken. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. My dear friends, now this incident takes place in the Mount of Olives. What is this Mount of Olives? This Mount of Olives, Jesus enjoyed, prayed the solitude and have fellowship with the Father, with the Spirit in this place called Mount of Olives. In all of our lives, we need a place where we meet our Savior. We come together as a community and pray together. That is different from we take time, each one of us, and individually we spend time with our God. It is that intimacy with our God will become our power. It is the intimacy with our God is our power that will push us in life. Yes, before he began the journey, the King of Kings starts his journey from the place of prayer, from the place where he constantly encountered the Father. Yes, only with the power of prayer we can carry the cross. Yes, Jesus knows very well carrying the cross means it's a heavy thing. He is going to be humiliated. He is going to be scourged. He is going to be pained. He is going to be go through all kinds of struggle and pain. And his own disciples are going to run away. Judas is going to betray him. And they are going to make him naked in front of his mother. And they are going to crucify him among the thieves. Jesus knew all that. And it is in that Mount of Olives. He cried and prayed. Yes, Father, Father, take this cup of suffering from me if it is your will. It is in the Mount of Olives. In prayer, he got the strength. You know, before he went to prayer, his heart was so much broken, he said, my soul is unto death. And while he was praying, he even cried for a companionship, but the disciples were sleeping. He went to pray. The prayer enabled him to overcome the grief that the companions are not with him, the loneliness, and got the courage to do the will of the Father, to carry the cross, to die and save the world. It is in that prayer, on the mountain of Olives, he received. My dear, when he was about to descended, it is to the same mountain he went. And it's from there he went to heaven. And the angels told the disciples who are looking up, the Jesus whom you have seen taken, he will come back same here. Yes, Mount of Olives, life of prayer, life of personal encounter with God is very much important. This is what Jesus the King teaches us today. If you want to carry the cross, cross doesn't mean a burden for us. Cross is a life God gives to us whereby we fulfill the mission and vision of God. We join with the Father to bring God's salvation to the world. You and I are God's gift. God has sent us to accomplish His mission on this earth. And with our own human power, we can't have it. That's why in 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 3 to 5, it is written, it's true, we are living in the world, and with all that is attacking us from the world, we cannot handle the problems of the world with the help that comes from the world. We need the heaven to help us to handle the problems of this earth. We need the heaven to be part of us. Yes, my dear friends, that's what we read. And Jesus going until the disciples came, He never moved away from the Mount of Olives. He was still standing there, praying to the Father, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, Jesus Christ. He began His special journey of going to Jerusalem to offer Himself from Mount of Olives, life of prayer. Close your eyes for a minute. Surrender your life to Him. Yes, the Word of God will make you to move on in life. The Word of God will help you to break the barriers and to reach your destiny. And life of prayer will empower you to handle the situations. Jesus, O King, we are also praying. Please anoint each one of us with the life of prayer, and may our hearts hunger for You. May our hearts learn to speak to You and learn to hear from You. Jesus, when You prayed, You always heard the Father speaking to You. You are My beloved Son. I have glorified You and I will glorify You. Yes, Lord. It is in prayer, it is in union with the Father, in your personal prayer, you poured out all your struggle to the Father. Help us also to develop this intimacy with You, because the problems of this world will take us away from You, Lord, and take us to wrong places, Lord. If that should not take place, if You have to be our Lord and Savior, we have to follow the same path which You have walked, Lord. Bless us, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
My dear friends, third we find Jesus is telling the disciples, go and untie. And that is needed for the Lord. Yes, that is needed for the Lord is tied up. So all that is tied up doesn't mean it has lost the meaning. Doesn't mean it has lost the life. Are you tied up with your weakness? Are you tied up with your sin? Are you tied up with all kinds of evil or all kinds of problems? Don't lose courage. Jesus is sending His word to untie you, to heal you, and the King of Kings Himself is with you. His presence is with you. Yes. The disciples noticed that the donkey is tied up. But the tied up donkey is also used by the Master. That's what we read in the book of Luke's Gospel, chapter 5. When Jesus came to preach the word of God, Peter was washing his nets. Not a single fish they caught that night. And the eyes of Jesus fell on the boat, which was tied up. Jesus spoke the word, sitting on the boat, casting away all kinds of unfortunate things from the boat. Maybe they might have thought the boat is a cursed one or waste. No. After listening to the word of God, the boat became a blessed one. And they said, Master, we tried whole night, we got nothing. But now in your word we go, and they got plenty. Yes, Jesus untied the boat and gave his word and brought plenty of fish. My dear friends, is your life tied up? Maybe you don't get any money. Maybe you are tied up in poverty. Maybe you are tied up in sickness. Maybe you are tied up in various situations. Don't lose courage. Your King is watching over you. The eyes of our King Jesus is looking on you. Tell him, Jesus, you are my King. Your eyes are upon me. That's what we read in Psalm 25, verse 15. Lord, when my eyes are upon you will untie my feet from all its clutches. My dear son, my dear daughter, what are the clutches in which your life is tied up? Look unto the Lord, and may his eyes fall upon you, and he will deliver you. Yes, as the tied up donkey became a gift for Jesus, you also will be used by Jesus. Don't lose courage. Knowingly, unknowingly, you fell into all kinds of sin. Now once again, the King is calling you. He is giving an opportunity to you. Return to the Lord. Otherwise, you will die where you are being tied up. The King of us is the King who gives opportunity to tie us. Untie all that is tied up and use them for his glory. Praise the Lord. And now we find the donkey is brought to Jesus, and Jesus sat over the donkey. And the donkey received the honor and glory of Jesus. Yes, the clothes they put on the donkey, all the honor they wanted to give it to Jesus, they gave it to the donkey also. My dear friends, carry Jesus, and the honor which Jesus has will be shared with you too. When we serve God, now, for example, I have seen many, many days, many times, every day, it's a marvelous thing to experience the glory and power of God. Yes, we have two schools of HIV children. And one of the schools is in one of the villages. And the father who is in charge, Father Francis, he was telling me, Father, I'm coming and I need the money because now it is locked down. I need the money. We were sending one of our fathers to go to the hospital to collect all the medicines. And that Father Francis also was coming with the books of those boys to collect the medicine. So kindly send money. That's what Father Francis said. As I was praying, I need to send 20,000 minimum to buy vegetables and fruits for our children. Can you imagine when we depend on God, what will God do? When the Pharisees were telling Jesus, why these people are praising Son of David, Hosanna, please tell them to keep quiet. You know what was the answer of Jesus? If these people don't praise God, even the stones will praise. Yes. God can use anything to bring glory and honor to God. You know, when Father Francis is coming, I need to give at least 20,000 to him. And as I was praying, do you know, a lady phoned to me. That lady, I know them well. They are a group of people. They love me so much. They are the people who sweep the roads at night time. Night time, there won't be much vehicles. So the whole night they work. They are very poor people. And you know, They all of them collected the money and they had sent 15,000 rupees. Next day morning, I have to give the money. And early morning, that lady called me, Yesumani, and said, Father, we are putting 15,000 in your account, Google Pay. Please take and use it. I had already 10,000 in my account. Now, what I need to pay for my children, I have enough and more. We have a king. It's true, our needs are new needs. It's true, we have new problems. But our God is a living God. Yes. Yes. When we commit our life to Him, when the donkey said yes to God, and it could have run away because the strangers were untying. No, the donkey obeyed and it came and offered itself to Jesus. And it received the honor that Jesus received. My dear, your life is once on this earth. Your mind and heart may say there are many things you can achieve in the world. You can build homes, yes. You may need it. You may earn money, gold, silver, and many other things of this world. Many things we need for basic things. And we may even try to hoard it. But I tell you, commit your life to God. Don't allow anything to come in between you and your God. Let the first priority of your life be to be in the hands of God. Life is to be in the hands of God and allow God to fulfill His purpose in your life. That's why Jesus said in Matthew 6:33, seek Him first and everything needed for your life will be given to you. Yes. God will honor us. Do you want to experience the honor of the Lord? Do you want to experience the power and glory of God? The easiest thing is learn to surrender your life to Him. Tell Him, Jesus, I am yours. Tell Him, Jesus, all that I have is yours. You said, Lord, that it is needed for the Lord. Yes, Lord, I am needed for you. Do you want to pray for your husband transformation? Tell Jesus, my husband is needed for you. I will dedicate him for you. My family is needed for you. Yes. Constantly say, Lord, we are needed for you. When we surrender to Jesus, and Jesus will accept it and bless it and give it back to us with His glory and honor. The donkey, when it gave itself to Jesus, Jesus shared His glory. And the donkey was honored. And Jesus was going to Jerusalem with that donkey. Today you and I are the donkeys. Give ourselves generously. Your time. Get up early morning. Seek Him. And you will find Him. Choose Him as your priority. First priority in life. And everything will be given to you. Yes. Now as Jesus was sitting on the donkey, the people, they had their own clothes. They removed their clothes and they put it on the floor. Welcoming Jesus. Yes, Jesus went over them. The clothes are symbol of our own lives. The word of God says, those who are proud, God will not accept them. But those who are humble, He will always raise them up. That is the work of the king. Though He is the king, He will see our heart. And if our heart hungers for Him, if our heart carries our families along with us, we don't tell our wife, you are good for nothing. No, she is the companion God has given to me, trusted me, and I will take the companion along with me. I never tell my husband, you are good for nothing. Look at that man. He is yearning. Look at you have become a drunkard. No. Carry him along with you with love as much as possible. Sometimes it is not that easy. It is very tough. Then look unto Jesus. You give your clothes to Him. Give your life to Him. Whatever you cannot handle by yourself, give it to Him. And He will lead you. Yes, He will cross over you. As he moves, his blessings, his anointing, his grace will come upon you. Sometime we keep our lives for ourselves. We throw our lives for anything and everything. That's why we read in the book of Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 15, verse 10, where the prophet says, man never realizes that his life is a gift of God. He forgets the one who has breathed his breath into us. Rather, he thinks life is a game. This world is a marketplace. And his life is meant to earn money. And even if it is any wrong way, it's okay. He is mad after money. And at the end, he will realize that money will make him mad and destroy all that God has given to him, the peace in the family. Money is needed, but keep the money, use the money as the Lord asks you to do it. Use your life, surrender to God. The people offered their clothes and honored God through the clothes of theirs. We read in the book of Zechariah, chapter 3. One day, God sent the angels to visit the priest called Joshua. And the angel came with so much pain and he was shouting. Joshua was wondering. He saw the angel and he said, why are you shouting? The angel said, look at Satan is there too. He is standing on your right side. Joshua said, Satan on my right side? How did he dare to reach this place? I am a high priest. The angels told him, by wearing the white garment, a person doesn't become holy. By doing something for God, no one becomes holy. Everyone should know their lives. And everyone should dedicate their lives as God wants them to be. So the angel said to Joshua, do you know how Satan dared to come near you and standing on your right side? If that of Satan, if that belongs to Satan is found in you, he will be with you. Yes, look into our lives. Is there that of Satan is in us? And definitely Satan will stand with us. And the angel said, he has defiled your cloth. Remove the clothes. And God gave him a new cloth. Yes. Today, surrender your life to God. Is your life is defiled? Is your life is disturbed? Is your life is ended up with all kinds of sin? The King is calling us. Throw away your clothes. Offer your life to the Lord. Surrender to the Lord. May the King come into your life and rule your life. Surrender. Close your eyes and talk to him. Yesu, Yesu Raja, Tu hai hamare Malik. Lord, you are the owner of our life. May all that we think, may all that we do, fulfill your will, O Lord. You have created us for us. May we be untied like the donkey. May we carry you in our hearts, Lord. Make us to carry your word and proceed in life. Give us the life of prayer, Lord, that we may have intimacy with you and have your power and anointing. Help us, Lord, to offer our clothes, our life to you, O Lord. We surrender all those who are praying with me. May all their lives be dedicated to you, Lord. You be our Lord and Savior. Forgive all our sins, Lord. Cleanse us with your precious blood, Lord. May we join with you in your passion, in your death, and in your resurrection, Lord. Surrender to him. Yesu Raja, O Malik, tum mere. maiye sochu maiye chaahu teri marzi puri karu
maiye sochu maiye chaahu teri marzi puri karu
yesu raja ओ मालिक तुम मेरे
यीशु राजा ओ मालिक तुम मेरे
जो कुछ मेरे पास है आपका वरदान है
मेरे पास है आपका वरदान है
मेरे लिए प्राण दिया मेरे लिए प्राण दिया अपना खून दिया
अपना
येसु राजा ओ मालिक तुम मेरे
येसु राजा ओ मालिक तुम मेरे
सरेंडर योर लाइफ टू हिम ऑल दैट इज obstacle to you, all that is frightening you, all that is disturbing you, all that matters to you, surrender to the Lord. Tere liye jeevan mera, tujhse hi prem karta. प्राण दिया
मेरे लिए प्राण दिया
परलोक खोल दिया
परलोक खोल दिया
येसु राजा वो मालिक तुम मेरे the Lord. I believe in God.
The Father, the Father Almighty, Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead.
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Let's pray to our King. for our church, for our Pope Francis, for our Archbishop, for our Patron Bishop, Govind Joji. We pray for all the priests and religious. We pray for all the Catholics all over the world, that we may all accept Jesus as our Lord and Savior and led by Him. For this, let's pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for people who are suffering with coronavirus. May the Lord's mercy come upon us and destroy the powers of darkness, the sickness. And may the Lord take over the sickness as the Lord and Savior and give deliverance to His people. For this, let's pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray for all those who are participating in the Mass. May they all be spiritually blessed. May they all receive all the blessings of this Eucharist, that their lives be guided and led by Your Spirit, and You be their Lord and Savior. Take control of their families. Wipe away their tears. Cast away all the sickness and pain, and give them Your relief, Your power, and Your peace. For this, let's pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let's pray in silence for all our leaders, especially our Prime Minister Narendra Modi, our Chief Minister Chandrasekhar Rao, all their ministers, all the officials, all the medical personnel, all those who are working day and night to remove the pain from the suffering people. May God bless them and their families. Lord, we surrender all our intentions to You. Especially I lift up the people who are praying along with me. May they all be guided by Your Spirit. You be our Lord and Savior and King. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
To praise You, lift our hearts and say, we are here to give You the best that we can bring, and it is our love. Pleasure and delight, heart and mind and will that say, I love You, Lord.
Pray, friends, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at Your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and good of all His holy church.
Through the passion of Your only begotten Son, O Lord, may our reconciliation with You be near at hand, so that though we do not merit it by our own deeds, yet by this sacrifice made once for all, we may feel already the effects of Your mercy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It's truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For though innocent, he suffered willingly for sinners and accepted unjust condemnation to save the guilty. His death has washed away our sins, and his resurrection has purchased our justification. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Jesus is the King of Kings. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus is the King of Kings. Lord, we lift up your name. With our hearts filled with praise, we exalt in the Lord our God. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Savior, Savior of the world, for my cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Thuma Bala our Archbishop, Govinda Joji our patron, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Especially we remember the souls for whom we offer this Mass. We pray for the families who offered this Mass. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. If any of you like to make the offering in this Holy Eucharist, you can keep your offering in your hand or your intention. We'll be praying for the offerings also, because the donkey offered itself generously. The people offered all that they had, even their clothes that were, they were covering their bodies, and God honored them. Lord, I surrender these people who are watching this Mass. Accept their offerings for you and for your glory, and bless them and use them for your kingdom, for your ministry, Lord. Praise the Lord. If you wish, you are welcome to offer your offerings through Google Pay, and we will bless all of you for every offering that you give it to us or to our children. Lord, kindly accept the offering of your people and bless them and their families. Let's pray with confidence to the Father the words our Savior gave us.
Our Father in heaven, holy be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Do not bring us to the test, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always,
and with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
This is the Lamb of God, the broken bread, turn out to be source of life. He is our King, comes into our broken lives and make us life-giving. Happy are we who are called to take part in this meal of love.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Mm-hmm. Nourished with these sacred gifts, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that just as through the death of your Son, you have brought us to hope for what we believe, so by his resurrection, you may lead us to where you call, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Let's go to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
So once again, we wish you all a blessed Holy Week. And you can join us for every day. We have the Holy Mass. And on Maundy Thursday, we have the worship. And we have the Holy Mass in the evening. At 6 o'clock in English, as well as it will be in Telugu, in another place. And also we will have the Friday, 9 o'clock, we will have the Way Up the Cross. And we will have at 3 o'clock the adoration of this cross and other worship of the liturgy. And Saturday night, we will have the Eucharist Mass of the Easter Mass, as well as Sunday's Mass. So you are welcome to join us.